Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my UMass Minutemen Dynasty in NCAA 13. We've hit the offseason, we've finished Season 2, and we've got some offseason work to do before starting Season 3. This was all done in a live stream before I went on vacation, but if you don't have 10 hours to sit down and sift through that, I have condensed it for you. Yes, you're welcome. Junk Johnson is at 77% job security after the end of the season, looking pretty good as far as head coaching goes. So we're going to skip the coaching carousel because we have no plans of leaving UMass in this dynasty. We want to build them up. So the notables in the coaching carousel, however, Rich Rodriguez is fired from Arizona. Well, yep, he gets the boot, as well as Beamer at Virginia Tech. So those are the biggest notables in the firings there around the NCAA. It is now time to see who's leaving UMass in this offseason. We'll start with the list here. I've sped it up a little bit, and pretty much everyone here, as a matter of fact, I think everyone, is leaving because of graduation. Surprise, surprise, we don't have anyone leaving early for the NFL draft or anything like that. Yeah, no, UMass is not turning out the pros, at least not yet. Kellen Pagel is a senior, was a senior, and he is out the door. You see Antoine Tharp is on that list. Levin Good, the kicker. Brandon Potvin, a very good, and has run out of eligibility as well. The Brandt brothers, I believe they're twins, Tom and Tim, they're done. And there's the biggest blow of them all. Rob Blanchflower, the Beast Flower, is done at UMass. We wish him well. And I don't know, who knows, maybe he gets drafted. Don't hold your breath, though. I don't think anyone for UMass is getting drafted. As a matter of fact, no UMass players will be entering the NFL draft. So, well, maybe later down the line we can get some guys who will be NFL worthy, but for now, that's not the case. No transfer requests, either leaving or coming in the door, so nothing doing there for transfers. We had a couple transfer to us last year. That's not the case here. So, time for the 5 weeks of off-season recruiting. I'm going to very much speed this up for you. We're going to look at where we stand week one, and then we're going to fast forward towards the later stages. So, like I said, if you want to see every single detail that went on, you can find the UMass Dynasty live stream that we did. Here's the saddest thing. Charles Smith, the quarterback, the coveted number two overall quarterback, did finally choose South Carolina and was a hard commit. So we've got to move on from that. Wesley Collins is an athlete, a four-star overall. Maybe he's a quarterback candidate. We don't know yet, but we'll have to look into that as a possibility. Maybe work one of our athletes into the quarterback spot and groom him. So we're still going hard on Wesley Collins. Want to get him in here. He's number one, is UMass on his board, and we're doing an in-home visit. So we got to get ready for that. Got to get this four-star athlete in to our roster. And we see Kevin Sanders as well at the middle linebacker spot, trying to work him. Carlton Powell as well, trying to convince all these guys that they'd have a good home at UMass. Walter Scott, a D-tackle, another one that we're pursuing, as well as Seth Clark. So we found some D-tackles, some middle linebackers that were better than what we already brought in. Ben Browning at the defensive end spot as well. Just trying to see what we can do with some of these guys. Thomas Hale, another defensive end. If these guys scout out well, maybe they'd be good prospects. Randy Smith, oh boy, we're fifth on his list and 260 points behind. I was just about ready to give up on Randy Smith, thinking he's probably going to decide elsewhere. But I decided to make another run at him in the week one of the offseason recruiting to see how that goes. Okay, fast forwarding to week four. Wesley Collins is in. Scott is in, Clark is in, and Carlton Powell is in. Four more recruits have signed on the dotted line and will be coming in to UMass. So here, standing at week four of the 5 weeks of recruiting, Randy Smith. Well, good thing we stuck with him because we're now number one on his board and we have a legitimate shot at him. Oh boy, that would be really big for the defense if we could land him. Ronnie Houston commits. Look at that. The 78 overall athlete, Ronnie Houston. He's 6'7", 223 pounds. Oh my goodness. He's going to be a good big target if we choose to use him that way, either at wide receiver or tight end. So we're still working Randy Smith. Excited to get him in. He'd be a 74 overall defensive end. Oh, that would be a big deal for us. We get Browning and Sanders to commit as we roll to week 5, and we're still working on Randy Smith. What exactly is it going to take to land Randy Smith? Well, we are number one on his board. We got to keep hitting it hard, though. And that's exactly what we'll do, trying to convince him that UMass is the place to come and wreak havoc on that defensive side of the ball. Okay, here we go. Recruiting is over. We are moving on to signing day. What do we have? Well, there it is. Randy Smith has chosen UMass. We get another 4-caliber player in there. And as a matter of fact, we get another 4-caliber wide receiver in there in Dunn. Wasn't expecting him, but he does sign on signing day. So here is a look at the recruiting class. Think we used up all the scholarships. Now, some of these guys were early on. You see a 41 overall in there. You see some really low overalls. They're never going to make the roster. You see the top classes, number 26 overall with the likes of Oklahoma State, North Carolina, Michigan State. Okay, we'll take that. So it's on to position changes now. This is namely where we got to decide where to put these athletes. So Ronnie Houston, like I said, he's 6'7", 223 pounds. Got to see where he fits in best. So this is exactly how you do this. Wesley Collins as well. Remember I said Wesley Collins, maybe a candidate at quarterback? Yep, he's a 70 overall at QB. But where is he if we look around? Oh, he drops significantly in other positions, especially anywhere from a skill position. So it looks like after searching around, he is going to be best overall at quarterback. So we're going to settle with that and groom him to be the next QB at UMass. Ronnie Houston now, 78 overall. He is not a good candidate at quarterback, a 40. He could be a halfback, although he takes a drop. Wide receiver is the best place, but we could use a tight end to take over for Blanchflower. He drops to a 70 there. There was some debate in the live stream whether he should be a tight end at that height or if he should be a big wide receiver target, because you know how they like him in the pros. They like him tall. They like him like Calvin Johnson Jr. But in the end, we decide he's a wide receiver. After looking at these skills, he's got the speed. He's got a lot of what we're looking for as a downfield threat. So we do make him a wide receiver. We make it official right here. So the athletes have been put in place. We've moved a couple other people around. Not real significant moves, just kind of minor tweaks here and there. And it's time to advance to the training results. Here we go. Let's see who put in the work in the offseason in the training room with the weights. Jim Mitchell's an 84 overall with a 94 speed now. Look at that. Ronnie Parker, who should have been with us all last season, broke his foot on the first catch of the year, and we were without him. That was unfortunate, but he's now an 81 overall with 90 speed. We've got a lot of speed, especially at the wide receiver positions. So you see Matthew Quinn advances to a 72. He's the best remaining quarterback on the roster. That doesn't mean he's going to be the starter. We're going to take a look now. Remember, we moved Wesley Collins to quarterback. And it is now time to cut this roster down. We are 9 players above the roster size we need. So, like I said, a couple of these recruits that we kind of aimed low to start with in the 40s. Yeah, you're not going to last on the UMass roster anymore if your overall is in the 40s. And I'm really happy to say that. I'm proud to say that. We've built beyond that point now where these guys in the low or even the high 40s, low 50s, are just not going to cut this roster anymore. So we're cutting the dead weight, getting this down to 70 players, and we're getting better by the day. That's exactly what we want to see from this UMass roster going forward. So we've done a pretty good job recruiting and making this a better roster. So as I said, Jim Mitchell is an 84 overall now in the backfield. Looking forward to that. As far as setting the preseason recruiting board, I'm not going to show that right now in this episode. I will jump right into that when we actually start recruiting. So I didn't do a whole lot to the custom schedule. I gave us an FCS team because we got to get revenge and actually put one of those teams out of their misery this year instead of losing to them And I wanted to go to Minnesota to play. I kind of like that idea. The rival this year is going to be Boston College, not UConn. We got Boston College on that schedule. The rest is conference play. So we're ready to go. Next episode will be very soon, and it'll be week 1 versus FCS East. Come back for more UMass football. We'll see you then.